Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode here in the Stesia Expert Mode Pack. How are you guys doing today? I hope you are doing well. So, previous episode, a smaller episode, but we did manage to get a couple of new things. And I want to discuss a couple of things that I did. So this is modular routers. So it's like the old factory routers or something like that, but cooler. So yeah, you can specify stuff, like I have an augmented module 3. So I went, I find the end, and I grabbed a couple of endstones, and I came back. So I didn't fight the dragon, so I just teleported back with one thing that I will show you. I have it in my chest. I'll show you that later on in the next episode. I don't want to spoil. So yeah, you can transfer like point stuff and transfer. So I also have put an augmented here, so it's sent one item at the time. So I have two of those, so I can make some energized stuff. So yep, that's cool. I have made some disenchanter stuff in here, some all over the place, all over the place. And I did play a little bit with creating a create world, and I found a couple of things that we can do that will be cool, but later. And yeah, there is this depot, so you can put stuff and you can have fans, and they will blow stuff away. Pretty neat. I believe you can put it also down below, so pretty cool, pretty neat. So I will also, in the previous episode, we had this thing in here. Yeah, this is the energy collector MK1 from Project T. So we have a transmutation table and stuff. That's very late game, but if you specify a specific block that takes like the end block of return take 576 RF MC. So yeah, have that with one redstone dust can turn into one block of redstone. So I have that, reroute it, and I have a crafting machine from Cyclic, but turn it back into dust. So pretty much it's unlimited redstone blocks and redstone, basically. It's basically that. Pretty cool. You can do it with glowstone, I believe, and coal. I believe there is a few things you can transform it or something. Like, yeah, pretty cool. I don't know about coal, but I will definitely try. But they're a little bit expensive. Quite a few diamonds, actually. And I had to make another windmill to power the crafting machine. But we already have quite a bit of stuff because right in here I made the Tomb of Alkal History. So went around in a swamp, fought a couple of witches, couple of creepers, couple of weathermen. I had a wither skull from somewhere. I believe I found it in the nether or something. So yeah, I made that, but in order to recharge it, it takes like blocks of redstone or glowstone on that, and 1,000, it's quite a bit. It's quite a bit. You need like 10 redstone block to charge about to 90. So yeah, it gets expensive, especially when we need nether stars. Yeah, that's quite a bit expensive. So somewhere right in here in this area I have marked. So yeah, mold forged chunks. So I will delete a couple of things in here that I don't want for now to be, and have next to that. So somewhere over here, if I can find the chunk border, yeah, somewhere over here I will set up a nice 9x9 grid of stuff to have a nice spawner. So let's get a place hoarder block. So light there, so 1 2 3 4. So oh, it's in hard to make. So there, 1 2 3 4. So there, here is where is the torch, or here where is the torch. And so we have to go around and make a nice room to have something nicely spawned dark room. So this is what I'm gonna do. Probably I'm gonna have to have some lights, I believe, in here to stop the mob spawning. That I'm gonna do, and probably have a GPS card, I believe, or at least an add-on in here to make this and 9x9. So iron, I think, or a copper one place. I think the iron one is gonna be the good one. So I have to go make that, finish this thing, and how we are gonna power it? Pretty simple, actually. Right there, I'm gonna do that. Yeah, that's a card, the GPS card from Cyclic. Fairly simple, fairly simple. Like, we can use it for this thing, the energy node. So, and now we put that there and we have wireless power. Yeah, and it's working. Yeah, it takes 400 Albref. So yeah, I'm using like the magmatic, I made the magmatic dynamo because I needed some more kick in terms of power wise. So probably it will start working later on, but not now. So I'm gonna do a couple of things, finish this thing, build there, put some lights, and start getting some liquid stuff that we want. See you in a bit, guys. All right, I'm back and I have built a thing. So I have a nice red alloy wire there with some lamps just to have some nice spawning. And oh boy, it takes a while to break. So put you there and do that. Although I don't know if we can get anything because I have two magma torches in here. So that can be a problem, actually. That can be a big problem. So let's remove them for now. And it's lit for sure, but it's definitely killing them. That's for sure. Yeah. Not fast enough, though. Okay, we are definitely killing them faster than, I don't know, kind of power that we can provide. We are definitely killing them. We got quite a bit. And liquid meat, actually, that we can use actually for food. But I don't see anything spawning. I think there is, yeah, I think there is the apotheosis mod. So which basically, yeah, we can break a spawner with silk touch. And after that, we can use like sugar clocks or spider or stuff like that. We can spawn, ignore near place entity, spawning conditions, spawn values, range, spawn caps. So yeah, redstone controlled, that's nice. And we can change the entity stuff. Really? Wow. But I don't know why it's taking so long to spawn stuff. But we can chase it with the time in a bottle, actually. Yep. Yeah, that's the cheaty way to do it. Yeah, I believe we can kill it as fast as we can get power in here. We just don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. But yeah, that was nice. So we have a bunch of pink slime, and I believe the pink slime, the balls, we are making it with that, and the pink iron, you need like a bucket, and we need that for this frame, for that, but illuminated for the machine frame. So build there anything that needs this RF tool building, and we are gonna need it. Environmental controller, that's actually one that I wanna get. That's actually a good one. Yeah, modular scanner, pairing blaze, crafter, ME fluid. So a lot of stuff goes in there, a lot of plain energistic stuff goes in here. And the dimensional builder. So quite a few things, but we have a few. I will let that there for now, but I would like to put like a few magma torches here and there, so to stop the spawning. But that's actually pretty nice. So I will go to sleep, and yeah, that's I think the apotheosis mod is the way to go to get stuff. But yeah, now that I have that, we have pink slime, we can get a couple of advanced machine stuff to progress a bit. So we need definitely one from the fluid base and one for the stasis chamber. So from one bucket we can get two of these diamond gear. Yeah, stuff like that. But yeah, since I'm not near it, it won't work. So yeah, we don't need it for now to be open. But yeah, so let me craft some more things in here. Probably I'm gonna need some more of these and see. Do I have any more wither skeletons? I have two skulls, so not much. I need to go find skeleton. And yeah, I have to go find the wither skeleton. I think there is a spawner inside in there. I believe a wither skeleton, you can get a wither skeleton spawner. So if that's the case, then that's golden. If I can get a wither skeleton spawner, because we're gonna have a limited wither skeletons. So yeah. See you guys in a little bit. Alright everyone, I'm back, and I have a couple of things that we need to make. First of all, yeah, I'm gonna do that, and we're gonna start making. Yeah, you can lock the recipe, which is cool, because we're gonna use it later for automation. That's the biggest thing, like the automation, that's the biggest the important thing. So we can lock recipes and we're gonna use it like for automation, pretty much everything. So yeah, the scrap. Yep. So I have done a couple of things in the between this clip, and oops. Exporting power. Why are you not exporting? Configurator. Nope. That was wrong. Yeah, now you are extracting. Okay, I got it. So why I'm making four? Because why not? I have the supplies, because I want also to make a mob crusher in order to have the wither later defeated. So that's nice. So we have that, and yeah, we can start making the ore base, the fluid base, and the affinity charges. I don't think we're gonna use that. The material workshop, that's definitely a good one for sure. I don't know what I wanna use it, probably for the glass, probably. But in order to make that, other things you need like lava stuff and water stuff and consumes things. So not really important, and we need the supremium, which is the one that we are after, so we can start getting like the machine frame. So we are in a good point. And yeah, I have made some emerald stuff. I started making some enchantment things. So I made the pick that has like that experience harvest and the experience boost 3. So every time I mine, and with the fortune 4 from my other pick, and I went in the end, I defeated the dragon. It's not a big deal, it was fairly cheap and fairly easy, so didn't show it, it wasn't important. And yeah, I made some end shelves, and I have some stuff that's kind of OP. So yeah, and I get a bunch of XP, so I got a little bit of enchanting that I did. It's very OP, very OP. And I made the atomic disassembler. Yeah, I made also an osmium compressor, an osmium compressor. So yeah, it's instant mine. It's just instant mine, the osmium compressor. And when I get the flux network that has like the, what we call it, the wireless charging stuff, we're gonna use it probably full time for mining and to just have a good sword and start building some other stuff in here. Yeah, started building some base in here. So what I have done, we need to gonna have a wither, so in case we lose power we need to be safe. So yes, I also increased the chunk loading force and stuff. It's just a couple of commands that I did, so we need more force chunk. So I chunk loaded this thing, a better chunk load as well as that. Why not? Since I have it, like it's not a big deal. It just force. So yeah, I made this. Yeah, I made this room. I dig it out all the way down to bedrock. We have tinted glass that is weatherproofed. I have a windproof ceiling, so in case anything happen and the weather escapes, we have a place that's gonna be safe. Yeah, indeed, it took too much time. There's some charcoal that I have, and I'm playing a little bit with create. We're gonna talk about that later when we start getting that cool place automated. But yeah, let's start getting some things made, like this stasis chamber. Oh god, I had a gas here. Where the gas here went? Oh god. You have to be kidding me, right? Yeah, see you guys in a little bit. All right, I'm back. I went, I killed a couple of fire beetles, and that was that all about. So we need also a mob crusher. We need a fluid base, which we need the pickaxe, and we need four of these, and we need some more plastic that I don't have, but I know a place where I can get the plastic. I haven't automated the plastic process, but I was able to make a cool thing. I made the Emperor's Chalice, which was just a couple of gas tier more and Endermere drop and a fuzzy thing, and there is infinite water bucket. Yep, infinite water bucket. And so you just, yeah, I have been using it. I've been using it, and this thing, yeah. And we don't have enough power. Now we have enough power. Yep. Pretty cool, pretty cool. And also can you can disable to make it like store stuff. But yeah, I need to automate that. I need to make two things. One that makes just to have the one that has the plastic, and one that makes the rubber and then into dry rubber and then into plastic. So because liquid plastic, we are using it for recipes, so I need to step up the game in that. They're fairly inexpensive, but I need to find a correct spot to put them, so that's why I'm not gonna do it. So we need one of these. Oh boy, we need diamond gears. I'm running kind of low in terms of diamond ones. I need to get, like, I have some more. I have some more, but we need to find. I'd get rid of the smeltery stuff. I didn't need them at the point. We're gonna talk about that. Don't you worry. So yeah, that's why I left them. I would like to go faster. I don't know if it's a config. If it's there a config to change that, I will change that. Like, use more power to make that go 3 times faster. Oh, absolutely, yes. And I'm one piston short. Okie dokie. And yeah, I remember I set up a small automation here to make 3D wood planks with the casting bench and stuff like that, because I was starting making it with buckets. So, yep. And we have four of these. So we have a station chamber, we have the mob crash, and we have the base. And I think I have the lens. And yeah, so let's get some gates and a cell. Cell, and we need also a tank. Tank wise. I'm gonna make a jumbo tank. And we need a basic fluid cable with a configurator. Alright everyone, so I have to make a cut and a small change. So this is an ender cell, and you put a cell from power inside, and you have a bunch of channel. So I made a harder one and I put a simple cell inside. So let's see it. So I put, I believe, a basic cell with a hadron energy cell, ender cell, and you have this gate. So I have the hadron ones, I believe. No, but I have some basics ones to be made. So fairly simple. Like I had some more supply, I had to make some more diluted stuff in here to make all of this thing. And what that does, it's basically like wireless power. Like you have that, you make those, and you make four at a time. So it's not that expensive, but it's a little bit of expensive, but not that expensive. But for the thing that we want to do, it's perfect. It's perfect. So yeah, I use it one in here just to test it out. So you can see you put the channel that you want, you have a cell, and it transfers power. So probably I should have you run with redstone, and you let's kill you. Okay, they died. So let's turn this off and show you what I did between that cut and the previous one. So I'm in here, I made the small thing. So this is the station chamber. I have a gate on top of it, so it's powered on. And yeah, so it uses, I don't know if it's truly 1000 RF or something else. If it was 1000 RF, I probably will be dead by now. I'm not so sure. So we have the glass, I made the ferro lantern just to have some nice things. So I have the laser bench with the laser, I have the jumbo tank, I have it to automatically output in the top, I have an energy cell, I made the second one with a gate on top, and we have the laser drills fired up. So that's the moment of truth. So I have the mob crusher in case I need to kill that wither, but I don't think I'm gonna set it up actually, because I don't wanna kill it, and I don't think I'm gonna have some problems. So we need some soul sand. I gather the wither skulls that I needed from the wither spawner from the blood magic area. So nope, I don't wanna go inside that thing. So probably gonna have to do this on the top side, like so and like so. And we have, yes, and it's trapped. Looks like it's working. And we have 10 mil buckets of wither gas. Wow, it's taking a minute, can't we? I'm afraid I might kill my power right in here. Yep, I'm killing my power or something. Yeah, that was that. That's nice. Okay. That looks like it's working. Not as I wanted fast, but because I don't have enough power to run it. But it's working. Sorry about the noises. So recent with their That was a bad idea actually, but let's see how our power is going. I don't think it's gonna despond if I leave actually, right? No, it's chunk loaded. Did it despond or something? How my power is doing? So this is 16th, this is definitely working. This is, I think we're fine. We are fine in terms of power. Okay, we are good. We are good. Did it despond? No, it's here. And we are getting ether gas. Very slowly though. Not full. I believe we can do that. Okay. Nope. Seriously? It didn't work. You have to be kidding me. Yeah, sorry guys that you have to hear that. Oh my god, that's loud. Oh my god, that's loud. But it's working. It's definitely working. Okay, we have ether gas. There was easier ways to do it. There was like a way with the tinted glass and the passive way, but for some reason, while I was doing some testing in the creative world, it wasn't working. I don't know what I was doing wrong, but it wasn't working. Like, this thing was all the time breaking. So how much ether gas do we need in order to make the supreme? There is the infinite nuke. I don't know what that is. Mycelium reactor, I don't know what that is, and it looks like it's not working, so probably we don't care. So apparently to make a supreme frame we just need 138 packets. Okay, so not much, not plenty, but still not it's a significant amount in order to make some of these machine frames, and I'm definitely gonna use it quite a bit. So probably what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna leave the game probably running, and yeah, if we had more power I will take accelerate it a bit more. Like, yeah, it goes faster, but okay. So I made the 5th one, it looks like it's connected, it looks like it goes like a tiny bit faster, I believe. I'm not so sure, but I believe I could put like 2, 4, 6, 7 more and make it a little bit faster, but I don't know if my power can handle it. Like, I have a magmatic dynamo that basically does the muscle work at the moment, because I kind of did upgrade it to the max. Let me show you. I've been doing a couple of things off camera, like figure out my power source. It's gonna be a big thing. So yeah, I have a magmatic dynamo with a resonant component and some upgrade stuff like this. So yeah, while I was making other things, I'm like, let's make one extra so I can have like it maxed out at 600-400 a ref. So that's not bad. Like, we have 15 here, I think, and another 100 here. So technically, and I have like a lava pump in the nether, so we have infinite lava, kind of. So probably I could make some more. It's gonna take few resources more, like to make 7 of those, but I will definitely probably gonna do it so I can speed up things, because when we killed the Wither in here, I had made about 8 more of these, and yeah, I have them making redstone blocks, and we have about 638 of those, plus a few more in here, and oh boy. When this, what? When that happened? Yeah, that was a big thing that I did there. Okay. It's okay, we've got some gunpowder, some coal, but that should have gone a little bit faster now, since I made this thing a little bit better. But yeah, so we have redstone blocks, and we need redstone blocks, because apparently to recharge the tome, it's gonna take about 110 blocks of 111 like blocks of redstone, and probably we can make barely 4 nether star per time per the recharge. So yeah, that's quite a bit of blocks of redstone. So I will leave that running. I could make it bigger if I want, but it takes diamond blocks, which I don't have. But I could definitely like make stacked go, like probably duplicate that from this side and just have the pipe in here. I could do that. That will be easy enough. And yeah, so longer episode, very long episode this time around. I spoiled you this one, guys, and it took a minute to get there. I will let the thing running to get some ether gas and prepare for what we need next, because we need a couple of things. The supremium, that's easy enough. We need to make a couple of new frames that I'm gonna do, but this one we need some resonating one, some pink slime ingots. That's fairly easy. The resonator, I have to make the starlight infusion machine. This is fairly simple now, I can do it. And so yeah, we need endearium glass, that's easy. Lumis gear, that easy. We are in the frame, we are getting there. Elementium, and elementium comes from the alchem, so botania stuff. So this is what we have to work in. So yeah, have a couple of magic stuff to do, probably start cleaning a little bit more, and I will see you guys in the next episode of Stacia Expert. We did a big thing today, big thing. See you next time.